Okay, let's take a look at an example of applying this procedure we've just talked about. Now, in this case, what I want to do is work with the OpenStreetMap data for the city of Chicago, Illinois, in the United States. I chose this because Chicago is my hometown. Now, we looked at an example from this data set in a previous lesson when we were talking about extracting data from XML. Now, in this example, we're going to take a look at a small part of the cleaning that we would need to do for this data set. This is all human-entered data, or for the most part, human-entered data, so it is especially dirty. What I'd like to look at here is auditing street types. So, for example, avenue. One thing we might be interested in doing with a data set like this is harmonizing all of the data so that we have just one way of writing something that's an avenue. Alternatively, what we might actually be interested in doing is encoding the fact that this is an avenue somewhere in the tag set for this particular address, or encoding it in some other way. Okay, so the type of data that we're going to be getting in to our auditing routine is an entire street name. And what we're going to be extracting is just the street type. And then taking a look at all of the different street types that are mentioned in the data set that we have. Now, the data set that we're going to work with here is actually only a fraction of the complete Chicago OpenStreetMap data set. In this case, we're going to be working with about 20% of the total data set. The entire data set is almost 2 gigabytes. So for text, that's a pretty large data set. Okay, back to the code. So as I mentioned, we're going to be getting street names. And what we want to do is we want to recognize types from street names. Now, I'm going to use Python's regular expression module in order to parse out the street types. So let's take a look at the regular expression that's here. Okay, we're going to match a sequence of non-white space characters, optionally followed by a period. This is to catch abbreviations like AV or ST as an abbreviation for street. And this match must occur at the end of the string. Now we're going to use this regular expression right here. And each time this function, audit street type, is going to be passed a street name, we're going to do a match against that string looking for something like AV or avenue or street. Okay, let's take a more holistic look at this particular piece of code. Now again, this is just a small portion of the type of auditing that we would want to do. So the way I've set this up is the main routine here is called audit. And what audit is doing is it's looping through this XML file using the SACS parser that's part of the element tree module from Python. Let's just take a look there. See? And in this case, I'm actually using the C implementation of this particular module. So I'd encourage you, again, to go take a look at the documentation for XML eTree, in particular the element tree module. Okay, now what we're going to be doing here is looping through that file. We're going to get one tag at a time here. And what I'm doing each time is asking the question, is this a street name? Now, if we were doing a full auditing pass, we might actually have multiple things that we're checking here and be generating multiple types of audit data. In our case, what we're going to be doing is essentially creating a record of all street types that we find in this data set. So let's go ahead and run this. Okay, and here's our output. Now, what I did here was essentially keep a record of the number of times I saw all the different street types that my parser recognized as a street type from the street name. We can see that we've got 4 different forms of avenue, the most common one being the full word avenue, and then av as an abbreviation without a period, although there were several that had a period. And again, remember, this is only 20% of the data type. Okay, the other thing that's nice about auditing the data this way is I would have forgotten about street types like court, for example. And I've actually got 3 different types of court represented here, and probably also boulevard. And we can see that that also is represented. So what we've done here is essentially audit all of the street types as entered by the human editors of the OpenStreetMap data. Now what we would do with this particular type of data is then decide, okay, what type of cleaning is necessary? Do we want to convert all forms of avenue into the full word avenue and do something similar with all of the other street types? What type of capitalization do we want? Do we want something that looks like this, or do we want just the first letter capitalized? And then finally, we can see that there are lots of things that actually matched our parser, which are not in fact street types, so we need to be careful about that as we're actually doing the cleaning so that we don't in fact introduce further errors into the process. Okay, so I would encourage you to take a look at this code, which is shared with you, and make sure you understand how it works. The next step then would be to actually use the audit data that we have here in order to figure out some cleaning tasks for street types. And again, as I mentioned, this is just a small portion of the type of cleaning that we would have to do for this particular data set.